break down the elements for us. We saw the model when you unveiled it in March, but it was on television. What should we expect from this National Cathedral? What is it? What makes it unique?
So I think the directive is that this project is not just building a building, but it's also about understanding the monumental core of Ghana. There is a monumental core, and most Ghanaians probably don't understand it. There's State House, which is built with the conference center across the road from it. And you can say at the head is the Cemetery of Heroes. You can imagine that as a head and two wings. The cathedral becomes the sacred space of the monumental core and a people's landscape that completes this monumental core of commerce, parliament, sacred space, and honoring our ancestors and those whose blood is shed for us. That then creates a space. A sacred space is also a place for the people. It is a place not for just the elite, but for the people of Ghana to have as a gathering and convening space for the deep faith we have. We are more than 70% Christian in this country. There are more than 30,000 churches, but none that represents the people, the totality of the people. We have churches that represent each church in each group, but we have nothing which actually expresses our national pride about our spirituality, which is a very important part of our culture. But also, that the idea that we also have not just a building, but a landscape that people can come to, that they can feel is theirs, is very important to the way in which our democracy works and the way in which it's articulated. The building, you know, in thinking about it, is not just about making a church. It is really a state space that can celebrate spiritual things and can be multi-faith. I think the president and the bishops are saying it can be absolutely about expressing the spirituality of the nation. But the building also is a place of education. It's about teaching music, religious studies, about engagement. It's about a learning center. It's about a museum. And it's really offering another kind of opportunity in the Accra landscape. The building of cathedrals since, you know, we can remember from Karnak Temple to the Ark of the Covenant by Solomon, and we can keep going through Gaudi in Spain, through the Washington Cathedral to Westminster Cathedral by Wren. These things are built by cities that realize that they are cities that are emerging, and they're built to do two things. One, to speak about their sense of their future, that they believe in themselves and they have a projection into the future. But they also consolidate that the city is grown up. It is a metropolitan place. It's a place where things are happening. So it's working on a lot of levels. It's really something that is a very powerful moment. And it happens, really, you can only build a national cathedral once, unless if it gets broken down. So there's a moment in any kind of forming, any nation's forming, where this moment comes. And when you build it with all your might, because you're glorifying something that is beyond just the mundane. It's not a hospital or a housing estate. It is something which is about ideas, and it's about encapsulating the aspiration of the nation into the future. And why is that important? Well, as I said, architecture matters. If you go to Paris or you go to a city and you see dignified monuments around you, you're proud of your city. And you feel that the city has a relationship both to the past and communicates to the future. And I think that this is something that we underestimate. When you have around you monuments that don't have the dignity of the aspiration that you have in yourself, it can wear you down. And architecture's role is to reinforce that. When you see a beautiful park made that you can use, then you see the road made that is better, you feel better because you feel your city's getting better and things are going on. The spiritual is just as important in that. And to have a space that is a national spiritual space is critical to consolidate this idea that we have about ourselves as Ghanaians and how we see ourselves in the future. We believe in the spiritual, but we also believe in the power that it has on our society in edifying it and in supporting it in its agenda for development. So I'm incredibly honored by this project, and also I was at first shocked. It's like, a church? We don't need another church. There's 30,000 churches in Ghana. But it's like, this is not a church. This is a symbol about the president's agenda about development, but also talking about the nation of Ghana and how it wants to project itself. It's interesting to me that as soon as we unveil the images, because it's a church that's based on our national culture, you know, the research into, you know, our culture, our Durban culture, the kind of the way in which we celebrate our kinship, and that relationship to our religion is very close. So the building is very specifically a Ghanaian building. It's not even a building. It's not like a Gothic cathedral that we're trying to replicate. It's a unique building that comes from our understanding of our modern democracy and our culture as it evolves, to make a modern statement about that, which is talking about where we are in Ghana now, and in a way gives an image to the future generations about what we thought of ourselves now and how we want to go forward. That we don't want to leave our culture when we modernize. We want to infuse it into our buildings to make a unique place, which makes us proud of who we are.
Quickly, let me push you on this one. What have been your thoughts on the response of citizens to this design of yours?
it's been absolutely interesting. And I think that all projects that are not fully clear to people split people. So, you know, you get people who go, oh, we don't need this. We want to build a hospital or a church or, you know, something. Mm-hmm. And then you get people who go, we totally get it. This is incredible. It's been interesting to see both things. And I think that that's healthy because it means that there's a debate in society about it. But the true merit of what this project will be when it's built and people see what it does. It will be an extraordinary employment generator. It will lift skills. It will bring new technologies to this country that are not present. It will elevate us in the world stage as being a country, an African country that believes in progress and uses its people to deliver that progress. These are not things to be underestimated because they help the development goals, even with one small thing like that. But because it's such a symbolic thing, it can have that kind of resonance and power. I think that it's natural that some people are just dismissive because, you know, we have poverty and we have incredible aspiration. But we are a continent that's probably the last continent developing. So we're going to have this binary. You know, we're going to have this binary. We're not going to be able to solve all of poverty before we start building monuments. We have to do everything at the same time to bring it all up. And I think that that will cause a lot of frustration for people. But also, I look forward to the change of the image of Ghana from being about a dependency, begging bowl kind of country to one that actually is mobilizing, growing its middle class, growing its elite, growing its intellectual base, growing its citizenry, the people who build the country, growing its farmers, growing its communities, and bringing them into the future and giving them purpose and life. You know, this is very important.